Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Bo, tell me what you remember about current density.
Sure. Current density equals current over cross-sectional area.
And what is the symbol for current density?
I don't...
It's uppercase J.
Right. And we can substitute the equation you just derived for electric current into the equation. Cross-sectional area cancels out. And we get that current density equals N.
Charge carrier density.
Charge carrier density times drift velocity times Q.
Charge per carrier.
Yeah.
We also know current density equals conductivity times electric field. The symbol for conductivity is a lowercase sigma, and conductivity is a measure of how little a material opposes the movement of electric charges. And conductivity is a fundamental property of a material.
But that equation does not actually work for all conductors, right? I mean, some conductors are non-ohmic.
Yeah. Current density equals conductivity times electric field is one version of Ohm's law, and conductors which follow Ohm's law are called ohmic. Conductors which do not follow Ohm's law are called non-ohmic.
Very nice, y'all. Realize an electric potential difference across a wire is what causes current in the wire, and we're assuming the electric field created in the wire is uniform. That means the magnitude of the electric potential difference across a wire equals the electric field times D, a distance parallel to the electric field. We derived that equation in a previous lesson. However, rather than using D for the distance in the electric field, we will be using capital L for the length of the wire. That means the electric field in the wire equals the electric potential difference across the wire divided by the length of the wire. We can substitute that in for the electric field in the current density equation, and when we solve for electric potential difference, it equals current density in the wire times the length of the wire divided by the conductivity of the wire material. We can substitute current over wire cross-sectional area in for current density and solve for the electric potential difference across the wire. Notice that parenthetically in the electric potential difference equation, we have wire length over the quantity conductivity times cross-sectional area. This is defined as the resistance of the wire. The symbol for resistance is capital R. I will point out that typically resistance is defined in terms of resistivity, lowercase rho, rather than conductivity. Resistivity is a measure of how strongly a material opposes the movement of charges. This makes resistivity the inverse of conductivity. And just like conductivity, resistivity is a fundamental property of a material. In other words, the resistance of a wire equals the resistivity of the wire material times the length of the wire divided by the cross-sectional area of the wire. Realize this equation for the resistance of a wire requires that the wire have uniform geometry. In other words, the cross-sectional area needs to be constant over the entire length of the wire. And now that we have resistivity, Ohm's law is often given in terms of resistivity instead of conductivity. That means electric field equals resistivity times current density. And that brings us to the more common form of Ohm's law. Bobby, what is the form of Ohm's law which you are more used to working with?
Well, we know we can replace the parenthetical expression with conductivity in it to the one with resistivity instead. And we get electric potential difference equals current times resistance. Yeah, that is the equation for Ohm's law which I am more familiar with. And I will point out again, that not all materials are ohmic. Only objects made from materials which follow Ohm's law, this law, are ohmic.
And we can solve that equation for resistance to show that resistance has units of volts over amperes, which we call ohms, for which the symbol is uppercase omega.
The unlucky horseshoe.
Unlucky because it is upside down.
Bo, what are the units for resistivity?
We can rearrange the resistance equation to get resistivity equals resistance times cross-sectional area over length. The units for that are ohms times square meters over meters, which are just ohm meters. The units for resistivity are ohm meters. I never really understood the difference between resistance and resistivity. I mean, resistance, resistivity. They really sound the same to me.
Okay. Well, resistance has units of ohms, and resistivity has units of ohm meters, so they clearly are not the same.
Resistance is a property of an object. Resistivity is a property of a material.
Sure. I think I get it. One specific resistor has a specific resistance. However, many different resistors made out of the same material will all have the same resistivity.
Exactly, because resistance is a property of an object, and resistivity is a material property. Two objects can have the same resistivity, but different resistances if they are made of the same material. However, they have different lengths or cross-sectional areas.
Yeah. Yep.
Thanks, everybody. Now, please realize the resistivity of a conducting material typically decreases with temperature. To remember this, consider what we know about superconductors. Superconducting materials have zero resistivity and require very, very low temperatures. So, clearly, resistivity decreases with decreasing temperature. In this class, unless otherwise stated, the resistivity of conducting materials is considered to be constant regardless of temperature. And remember that resistors usually convert electric potential energy to thermal energy, which can increase the temperature of the resistor and can increase the temperature of the resistor's environment. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.